right, we're only going to have one screencast dealing with monopolistic competition. So let's start with the characteristics. Monopolistic competition has many small sellers, typically. They are price makers because they sell a differentiated product, and there's free entry and exit of firms. And some of these characteristics should sound familiar because they're like perfect competition. So if we look at the name for this industry segment, monopolistic competition. So like perfect competition, we have the competition word. And then like monopoly, we have characteristics that are like the price maker and a differentiated, or in the case of a monopoly, it's a completely unique good. But in the case of monopolistic competition, it's differentiated products within a category. So in monopolistic competition, there are aspects of perfect competition and monopoly sort of being combined. So like perfect competition, they can have positive economic profit in the short run, and so can the monopoly firm. But because they have free entry and exit of firms, new firms can enter this segment. And so the firm that may be enjoying short-run positive economic profits, it won't persist into the long run because these new firms enter and it drives down the price. Let's look at how that works graphically. Graph on the left is emphasizing the short run. So initially, the firm may be the only one in this segment of the market. So they introduce a new product. They're going to have a high price based on the demand curve, right? Just like the monopoly, they're going to set their price based on what the consumers are willing to pay. So they pick their output quantity, where marginal revenue equals marginal cost, and then they look up to the demand curve and set that nice high price. So price is high, and with price higher than average total cost, they are generating positive economic profits. So each firm sells a different good or slightly differentiated good, so each one faces that downward sloping demand curve like the monopoly. The problem comes in as these new firms enter with the free entry characteristic, they're going to suck away some of the business from the existing firm. So as that happens, that means the price is going to have to fall. And as the price falls, then the profits for that firm is also going to fall. And just to sort of show you how that price is going to fall, right? If we think of new firms and decreasing demand, we're going to see that on the next slide as I flip to that in a moment. As the price falls because the demand for this product falls, then the firm's profit gets squished away. So why does the price fall? If we think back to a perfectly competitive market for a moment, we have the supply and the demand curve, and the interaction of the two set the market price. As new firms enter the market and they introduce new products, people who might have purchased the original product now see that there are alternatives to choose from. And so the demand shifts downward or inward to the left. And you can think of this as being related to the related goods factor. So there are competing goods now in the market, and it decreases the demand. And as the demand falls, it drives down the price. So the new lower demand curve means that the initial firm's price will have to go down. So to summarize the outcomes in the short run and the long run, in the short run, one firm or very few firms, they charge a high price, they are keeping their quantities low in order to maintain that high price, and they're generating higher profits. And because of the free entry of firms in the market, it results in prices falling over time and lower quantity still. Market size may be growing because there are many more firms selling, but individually the firm actually has to cut back on its output in order to try to maintain price. And because the market's pushing the price down, it's selling a lower quantity at a lower price and effectively becoming more like a perfectly competitive firm where profits are either zero in the long run, or if things go very badly, they can actually have losses in the short run. And then they have to decide whether or not they even want to stay in this market. And that pretty much wraps up monopolistic competition.